Oh my god, we have a lot of dogs. We have 2 weeks worth of dogs, which I believe you said it was 25.
Awesome.
So, we might be a little brief because this is going to be a long video whether you like it or not. So let's get started. First, we have this beautiful Bernese Mountain Dog female. Look at her. She's not like, I don't know, she's just got it going on. She's beautiful. She's really fluffy. She's got a gorgeous coat. She's got a cute little pink speckled nose. Super cute. And she's going to be super big. Large and in charge. These guys are around 100 to about 125 pounds. They're gentle giants. They're beautiful. They do shed. These were bred for mountain rescue, so they're into their people. They like hanging out, going out, doing things. But they're mellow. It's not a high energy dog. It's not like a lab. So if you're looking for something a little on the slow pace side, that's absolutely beautiful and great with families, here is your dog. Or if you want something that's going to be smelly, like my meatball, we got an English Bulldog. This is AKC registered. This guy is perfect. He's beautiful. He's from a strictly English Bulldog breeder. His whole litter was absolutely gorgeous. It was all boys. A big family of boys. I feel sorry for him. He's got a really nice, big, deep nose wrinkle. The way everybody likes that English style, like I said, AKC. I'm figuring he's probably going to be between 50 and 60 pounds. These guys are super funny. They're really cute. They're awesome to watch them try and figure things out because of the way they're shaped. A lot of times they can't get over things, so they fall backwards, and it's kind of funny. As adults, they're lazy. They're stinky. Put that in the shed. English Bulldog guys, come and get me. All right, if you're looking for something a little bit on the slower pace and cuddlier pace, look at these guys. We have Cavapoo. Both are girls, they're both sisters. I think these are going to be, this one I think will be about 20 pounds. This one might be somewhere between 15 to 20, a little bit lighter. This girl here is the darker red color. She's got very cavalier-like markings. And if you look closely, you probably can't see it on the video, but this dog does have green eyes. Again, Cavapoos are non-shedding. They're intelligent. They are very, very sweet. And not too big, and they're not going to shed. So if you're looking for like a little apartment-sized dog, here it is. This one is the sister. Again, this one's a little bit lighter in color. It does not have green eyes. It's got your standard brown eyes, but she's pretty and she's sweet. She's a little nervous still. These guys just got here. And then if you're looking for something purebred that's super sweet, check out the purebred Cavalier we have. This is a boy. He's Ruby, and he's got a nice little patch running off his face. Cavaliers were bred for royalty to become and sit on people's laps and look pretty. So again, if you're looking for something with that kind of personality, we've got either the Cavapoos, which might be a little bit easier to train, and again, non-shedding, or you got the Cavalier here that will shed, but it's a purebred version. These are Papyrians. Half Papillon, half Pomeranian. These dogs are absolutely gorgeous. They're super sweet. They're tiny. They're probably going to be... One of them, this guy, is the biggest. This one, I think, would say maybe 8 to 10 pounds max, just to be on the safe side. And then we got this one. This is another boy. This is a brother. But he's super tiny. This one's only 1.9 pounds. This is like a teacup. So this guy's going to be delicate. This is not a cape dog. This is definitely a pocketbook dog. You got to take care of it. It's got to eat a lot, all that good stuff. But he's got the best personality in my opinion so far out of three. Right? Because you're a little brat. Super cute. I love the markings on his nose. I think they're really, really cute. Again, this guy is like a teacup size, maybe 4 to 5 pounds over. And then we have one sister. She's still a little shy. She's still shy. She's small too. She might be more like 5 or 6 pounds. She's a little bit bigger than the small brother. So she'll probably need to eat a lot too. These guys more delicate. Like I said, these aren't really good kid dogs. These are more like your single couple family kind of situation. You know, he's getting nervous. So like I said, we got two boys and a girl. The boys are little brats. The girl's still a little nervous. She's still got to come out of her shell a little bit. So don't come visit her and expect her to jump in the or anything. But this is a beautiful litter of dogs. Half Papillon, half Pomeranian. Papillons are those dogs that are being nailed by chihuahuas with gigantic ears. That's what this is. All right, so moving right along, we got some things that shed, we got some things that don't shed, we got things in different weight ranges. So let's start with this. This is a tween dachshund, a mini dachshund, I don't know. This dachshund we think is going to be between 12 and 18 pounds, which is smaller than a standard, but not as tiny as a true tween. So he's long hair, he's wild boar brindle, he's got really, really cool markings. He's super sweet. These guys are spunky, they like to play, they like to hang out, and most of all, they love to burrow in your bag, right? Because that's what they do, they were bred to burrow. It will go into badger's burrows. So if you got a farm, he'll hunt for you. If you don't, he'll just dig at your blankets in the morning when it's time to get up. Right? Now in comparison, we have this dachshund, which is a considerable amount smaller. The difference. She's definitely a true mini with Shetland. These are really hard to come by. She's probably going to be somewhere between 6 to 10 pounds max. She's beautiful. She's also long hair, black and tan. She's super sweet. I mean, I haven't had her all that long to totally tell you what she's like, but she's definitely a little sweetheart. She plays nice with others. So, teeny tiny female dachshund, or we have the other dachshund that's a little bit bigger, and that's a boy. Now, for these non-shedders that we got floating around in the same area, I have a brother and sister. These are Havanese Shih Tzu mixes. I really like these dogs. They don't shed. They're nice and hardy if you have kids. This is definitely a good dog if you have children that you're trying to keep entertained. They're well-built. Havanese and Shih Tzus are both built to stand kids, so you don't have to be so nervous that, you know, your kids are going to be too rough with the puppy or anything like that. The Havanese part of this dog pulls the nose out on the Shih Tzu, so the breathing is a little bit easier because Shih Tzus have that really flat face, so sometimes they can have breathing issues. It also makes these dogs very easy to train. Havanese are super smart dogs. Shih Tzus are a little stubborn, but they're smart when they want something, coincidentally, right? But yeah, like I said, these are cool. They'll train easy, they don't shed, they're hypoallergenic, so if you have allergies, you can definitely have these dogs. Again, if you have kids, they're definitely good kid dogs. Or if you have another dog that's kind of lonely, they just make a nice little companion, and they're not too big. Him, I think he's going to be somewhere between, I'd say 15 to up to about 18. He's kind of a chunker. She's a lot lighter. I think she'll be more like 12 to 15 pounds max. And dachshunds. He is chocolate and white, or liver and white, however you prefer it. He's got a really nice coat, he's got nice hair, he's so awful, he seems to be too oily, so he's gonna be a handsome Shih Tzu as an adult. These guys are about 12 to 15 pounds. Again, they don't shed. Shih Tzus can be a little bit stubborn, but they're always happy. They're definitely always happy to see you. These are like couch gremlins. They like hanging out with you on the couch. They were actually bred to be foot warmers, so they're bred to lay on things. If you have cold feet, come get yourself a Shih Tzu. You have the perfect one. He fits on the top of your feet just like that. Awesome. Awesome, awesome little guy. Check it out. Then, if you want something that's a little more spunky, you got a little bit more oomph to it, rather than something that's just gonna sit there and eat, you had a house in home. Check out our video. This is half Bichon, half Poodle. This dog is very intelligent, very easy to train. If you're looking for stuff with legs, this dog's got legs. In the body structure. Super sweet dog. It's very well-rounded. If you are by yourself and you want a companion dog, you can slap one of those vests on and bring it to Target with you and go shopping. This is a good dog. They're playful. Again, like I said, they're intelligent and they're phylogenic. I'm thinking maybe, I don't know, 12 to 15 pounds on this dog, but it may appear to be a little bit bigger. But it's got a light, beautiful structure. So we got some smaller ones, we got some like 6 pounders here. This is not the Beezapoo I just showed you, I swear to God. This is a multi-poo. Female on the Beezapoo, female multi-poo as well. Maltese and Poodle, this dog will be, like I said, I think 8 to 10 pounds, I think, on this dog. Not gonna shed, gonna be easy to train. Again, this is a pretty well-rounded dog too. You can have this dog by yourself. Again, slap a little vest on it and bring it everywhere with you. Or you can have a couple of kids to keep it occupied. Again, it's going to be a little bit on the smaller side, so you got to be careful if you have kids. But definitely, it's probably keep everything in. And again, trainability on this dog is going to be pretty simple. And again, if you have allergies, it'll be fine. Also, this dog. This is a silky poo. So this is half silky terrier, which is very, very similar. It's the Australian version of a Yorkshire terrier. They are known to have supposedly better coats. It's not as greasy as the Yorkie gets, but very similar in the fact that it changes to gray when the dog gets older. It's hypoallergenic. This dog will train really easily. And I think the dog is going to be around 6 to 8 pounds maximum. And this is an outfit. So be cool. Okay, moving along. What are we like? 15 dogs in? Are we done yet? Mini Schnauzer. Check out this Mini Schnauzer. It is a chocolate party Schnauzer. It's a female. Schnauzers are really cool dogs. They're spunky, they're tenacious, they're fearless, they're loyal. If you're looking for a good watchdog, but the dogs alert you that someone's coming to the door or whatever, you have a great dog for that. Like I said, they're very loyal. They're spunky and hardy. So if you have kids, this is definitely a really good kid dog. Especially if you have rough kids, they can take anything. Devoted to their families, and like I said, they're intelligent and spunky. So if you're looking for something with a really cool skirt haircut and in a cool color with green eyes, get someone. There's only one, so you better get it. And just in time, then this dog looks nothing like Schnauzers. Like this little dog. Schnauzers don't shed. This is an American Eskimo dog. It looks like a Pomeranian. It's not. It's bigger than a Pomeranian. It's going to be easier to train than a Pomeranian. It's also going to be quieter than a Pomeranian. American Eskimos were bred to be companion dogs. They're bred to hang out with people. Therefore, they want to be with you. This one will be about 20 to 30 pounds. They come in different sizes. They do come smaller. But this is the ones that were available to us, and she's got a really pretty face. We also have a brother, which I'll show you in a different clip with a different group of dogs. But again, if you're looking for something that's got the Pomeranian look, but you want it to be a little bit of an easier going dog, check out the American Eskimo. They're definitely really, really nice dogs. Thanks for flying. There you go. And then for our last one, catch me if you can. I caught you. All right, we're big fans of Merle over here at Puppy Experience, so we found this guy, and since he's Merle, we grabbed him. This is half American Eskimo and half Australian Shepherd, mini Australian Shepherd. If you watch our videos, you should know what a mini Australian Shepherd looks like because we carry those pretty often. They're pretty popular. This dog is going to be extremely intelligent. It's also going to be extremely active. This is not a puppy that you can bring home and stick in a cage for 8 to 10 hours and do nothing with. If you're one of those crazies that gets up and goes out and runs and jogs and hikes and does healthy things, then this is a great dog. I'm thinking this dog is going to be about 30 to 40 pounds based on his size and weight now. Again, this dog is super gorgeous. Just in time for tax season, get this puppy ready to do your taxes because, again, he's going to be really, really smart. They do shed, so if you have allergies, if you're really, really sensitive, this dog is not going to work for you. But if you don't have allergies and you're active and you want something cool and smart, come and get him because he's awesome. All right, cool. Check out this dog. It's a Lhasa Apso. Lhasa Apso's are related to Shih Tzus. They're in the same like species, breed, family, whatever. They're kind of like the big brother of Shih Tzus. Lhasas were actually bred as guard dogs versus the Shih Tzu that was bred as a foot warmer. So if someone tries to come into your house and take your stuff, this very ferocious 20 to 25 pound killer will protect you. Look at that face. No? I mean, that looked very scary. But yeah, that's what they were bred for. They do things like that. He'll definitely take down a robber by biting his ankles off, and they're relentless, so he'll definitely get the job done. Non-shedding, again, 20 to 25 pounds. This is a boy. He's got a really pretty face. He's got like those typical puppy eyes, you know. I hear Sarah McLachlan in the background when I see this dog's face. He's got shed puppy eyes. But he's super cute, he's spunky, he's playful, gets along with other dogs. So come get him. Get yourself a foot warmer and a guard dog. It's gonna be an awesome combination. And then for you that's trying to destroy my shoes, a mini golden doodle. She's really small. She's definitely should fit the 20 to 25 pound range. She's got a gorgeous coat. It's really nice and soft. It's definitely hypoallergenic from what I can tell. I don't see any shedding going on. It's all one layer. So she's very pretty, very cute. She's super spunky. She's got a great personality. Mini golden doodles are awesome. They train easy. Then you get that awesome all-American golden retriever family oriented type of personality. So if that's what you're looking for, we have it. Alright, so we have a little bit of a mistake. A couple of our breeders got in touch with us at the breeder that did the Australian American Eskimo mix. Kind of had some trouble getting rid of Kinky over here. Yes, I called the dog Kinky. It has a kink in its tail, so get his mind out of the gutter. It's not a Kinky dog. So we got a really nice deal on this dog. It's a cosmetic thing. The tail just, I don't know, grew in. But it is kind of technically defect. So again, we got a nice deal on this dog. It's cute, it's Merle, it's an Australian Shepherd Mini, Cairn Terrier mix, very strange mix. So yeah, the more and more I talk about this dog, the more and more I realize why we got a deal on it. Dog is young and very, very fairly priced, so if you like what you see, come down again.
You're laughing. This
dog is half Chihuahua, half Pomeranian, believe it or not. It does that typical Chihuahua thing where it like squeezes its eyes. She's a little girl. She's spunky. She's on sale too. She doesn't look like she's got Pomeranian hair. Unless you get really close and you really want to call. Again, we're helping some breeders out. They gave us a nice deal. We're giving you guys a nice deal. She's 8 weeks old. There's nothing wrong with these dogs. These dogs are perfectly healthy and even vet checked. My vet actually thinks this dog is cute. Yeah, like I said, we got a nice deal on a couple of dogs. And we're going to send it to you guys. So that's that. Like I said before, I have a brother and sister of the American Eskimos. The breeder, this litter, I think, was six or seven puppies, and only one was a female, and everybody else was a boy. So we agreed if we got the female that we could take in a boy, and again, extended this custody because she was having trouble getting rid of a ton of boys. The boys are bigger. He's a bit bigger than the sister. The sister, I would put, again, like I said, 20, 30 pounds. But again, same kind of dog, very intelligent, easy to train, these dogs are great with people. Alright, so check it out. And then, we had a Corgi not too long ago that was super cute and went really nice. I think this is from the same breeder, but this one was just a little left over, so if you're looking for a Corgi, this one is cheaper than when you get them in a basic price of Skyline. So again, if you're looking for a Corgi on a little bit of a discount, we have one. It's a girl. Corgis are tenacious, they're small, they're kind of like German Shepherds on stumps. Definitely an active dog, and they're very intelligent. The queen has a million of them, but apparently she can't get this one. So alright, for our closure dog, we have a husky here. Hello, Mr. Buster. He's very stiff and rigid right now. I don't know why. Huskies love this kind of weather. And they'll pull you to work if you get stuck in a snowstorm and you have a jerk of a boss that says you still have to come to work. And they're really, really smart. They're beautiful. They have beautiful blue eyes. Show everybody your blue eyes.
I'm taking shots in here. You want one? Yeah.